Welcome to all. Today we discuss hybridization and shapes of covalent molecule. So this discussion is also helpful all types of competitive level exams and all types of BSc students. And every competitive exam, one problem is most common: how to calculate hybridization and what is the shape? If we draw HCOA4, HCF4, so what is the shape of this type of compound? So we discuss on that discussion. So please follow the general configuration. At first we discuss here general configuration. So after our discussion general configuration, we also discuss the hybridization rule. Then we also apply our shortcut trick. Some general configuration is here. In case lithium, 1s2 2s1, and then in case beryllium, 1s2 2s2, then boron, 1s2 2s2 2p1, then carbon. On this sequence order, just p orbital filled here, 1 2 3 4 5 6, just p orbital filled here. So here the simple, we also follow here configuration. The we also say that this one is our inner cell, 1s2 is common for every case. So we can conclude and we can just write down here when boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon. So here we just say that here in case boron, the valence electron is present 2 plus 1 3, so 3 is the valence electron in case boron. Then carbon, here 4 valence electron present, and in case nitrogen, here 3 plus 2 5 valence electron present, and in case oxygen, here 4 plus 2 6 oxygen present, sorry 6 valence electron, and in case fluorine, here 5 plus 2 just 7, and here neon, in that case 6 and 2 8 valence electron present. So this one is our valence electron. So we can general conclude to show this configuration, this one is our valence electron. So this concept also help to predict our all types of problem. We just follow. We discuss one of the important topic is calculation of hybridization. So here the formula of steric number, V plus M plus minus Q. So here valence, here the V is the term of valence of electron of central atom. Then M is the term of number of monovalent atom. Number of monovalent atom is the M. The term is very, very important. Monovalent, it's not divalent. Then our plus charge is for anionic and minus charge is for cationic. So now we discuss how to apply this formula in our structure. Just follow. Here at first we discuss the structure. If we consider SnCl2, so my question is, what is the hybridization of SnCl2 and what is the structure? So we just get this answer by using this formula. So here if we use this formula, the Sn is present on that group. So here the valence electron of Sn is 4, that is our V. V is equal to 4, and then Cl is our anionic, sorry, Cl is our this metal of monovalent. So Cl is our monovalent, and this monovalent is also anionic. So here we can plus 4 plus 2, because here why we use 2? Cl2 means 2 chlorine present. So here 4 plus 2 and into half. So when we calculate this term, so 6 by 2 3, total answer is 3. So total steric number, S number is 3, but here on that structure SnCl2, here the 2 bond is possible, 2 chlorine take participate in bonding. So we can easily write here this, here 2 bond pair. Why we write 2 bond pair? Because here 2 Cl take participate in on bonding. So here total steric number 3. So here 1 is present lone pair. So we just when we follow the hybridization of SNCl2, so we can easily say that here if we when write down SNCl, so this one is our when S and a one is our lone pair is just participate. So here we just draw the structure of shape sp2 spp. So our hybridization is sp2 here page with containing one lone pair and two bond pair, and we just say that this one is called triangular sp2 triangular. So we easily say that we use this formula, we just calculate. So different example we also discuss, please follow this discussion. This one is our total slide. Now we discuss one of the important term is here, the number of sigma bonding. In that case this one when the central metal atom presents here and on that side here, so this one is called our linear, means sp. So when we go to sp2 with adding one p orbital, so the configuration is now sp2. So in that case sp2, this one, this structure of shape we also called here trigonal planar. We know that trigonal planar. When you go sp2 to sp3 with adding one p electron, so sp3 means tetrahedral. So sp3, when we here add one d orbital, then sp3 hybridization, then we get the structure. This one is our TBP, tetragonal bipyramid, sorry, trigonal bipyramid. So we can here write trigonal bipyramid structure. So if we go one adding with one d orbital sp3 d2, so we get this one is our octahedron structure. Octahedron term is, the name is very important. So if we go our next term here, we also show here pentagonal bipyramid. So this one is our pentagonal bipyramid. So here total hybridization sp3 d3, means sp3 d3, means total 7 here coordinate bond here, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So now we recap the total thing, everything. So we know that linear case, in case sp hybridization, we also know that this one is our single line sp, and in that case sp2, this one is our trigonal planar, sp2, simple. And here in that case sp3, here our structure is tetrahedral, this one is our tetrahedral form. So now when we go one add one of d orbital, if we consider sp3 d hybridization, then we get the trigonal bipyramid. This one is our name, trigonal bipyramid, and this one is our octahedron, and then this one is our, if you get consider sp3 d3, this one is our pentagonal bipyramid. Now when you give one of the example is here, in that case sp here NO2 plus NO2, normal NO2, carbon dioxide, this one all of the example CDI2, all example of sp. And if you get sp, then sp2, if you consider, this one is our BX3, means BF3, BCl3, everything. Then our CO3 minus is our example, CO3 minus. Then you get CH3 plus, all is our sp2, means planar, trigonal planar. And then if you consider tetrahedral concept, So here we know that sp3 is our, sorry, sp3 if you consider ch4 normal methane and then nh4 plus bf4 plus bf4 nh4 all our sp3, and then if you consider sp3b then you get XCO3F2, one of the important example, XCO2F2. Then you get PCl5, and then we also write down here SBF5. All are belongs to this trigonal bipyramidal configuration. And if you consider SP3D3, means this one is our, sorry, sp3d2, this one is our octahedron. So octahedron acf6, simple example, acf6, tef6, then sf6, example, etc. Then sp3d3, then we consider sp3d3 means if7, one of the important example. We also discuss all type of bonding. Please follow this discussion. REF7, etc. So if you just follow what is the similarity on that case by using hybridization concept. So in that case, sp here in case oxygen directly connected carbon dioxide, total dipole moment is equal to zero. So here the linear shape it can exist. But in that case, trigonal planar structure BX3, here the structure is simply, we can say that sp2, and here, so here total bond is 3, bx3, total sigma bond take participate 4, this one your sp2, sorry, sp3, bf4, and total bond take participate here 5, this one is our trigonal bipyramidal, total bond take participate 6, this one is our octahedral, sf6 normal. But now my question is, what is the case of lone pair? If you consider lone pair case, the things, the rule, someone changes. So now we discuss how much changes this rule in presence of lone pair. One of the important things we also discuss here. In case triangular sp2 hybridized, here presence two bond pair and if one lone pair, the shape is called V shape, and the example is SnCl2, PbCl2, SO2, GeF2, NO2. So in case tetrahedral sp3 hybridization, here if present one lone pair, three bond pair, then the shape is here. So at first I also say that you just draw the all structure with example in your copy, then you listen this discussion, just draw every structure, every point on your copy. Then if two bond pair, two lone pair, then it get with this type of shape. Then three lone pair, then we get the linear structure. So here we can easily say that this structure is like pyramid, so trigonal pyramidal, and this one is our V shape. Due to the presence of two lone pair repulsion, the bond angle is so much decreases, and this structure is exist on V shape, and this one is our linear, and this one is our trigonal pyramidal. So the example is given here, NH3H2O and H2O, and we also calculate, we also draw. So here in case trigonal bipyramidal, the structure is here, and TBr4SF4, this one is our one of the example. So now we can easily say that this one is our distorted tetrahedral. This one is our distorted tetrahedral. Distorted tetrahedral, this is structure. Then our second term is our, this one is our T shape. We just call T shape. Then this one is just linear is here. So we just case here the linear. We just say. So in case lone pair presents one lone pair, in case trigonal, we also know that trigonal bipyramidal structure is on this pattern, triagonal bipyramidal structure. But here, in case one lone pair presents, then the structure is distorted tetrahedral. This one is our T shape. This one is our linear shape. Then all is the example is present here. Now we also discuss how to all every type of problem solve. But here one of the thing is missing here. Octahedral case and pentagonal bipyramid. Now we also discuss. Now in that case octahedral, the hybridization is sp3d2. So we know that in case sp3d2, the structure is one lone pair when present and five bond pair. The shape is here, that is square pyramidal. So the example is BRF5, IF5, TA5 an example. This one when presents two lone pair and four bond pair, the structure is called square planar. So the example is ICL4, BR4, XCF4. So in case we also know that octahedral means here this one we called also octahedral. But in that case lone pair presents, the thing is happen here. And in case pentagonal bipyramid, this one is our distorted octahedral, we also discussed later. And then 5 bond pair, 2 lone pair, this one is our pentagonal planar structure, XCF5-. Now we discuss some example. Now here, one of the important problem is square pyramidal molecular shape is adopted, SOF4, XCOF4, SOCl4 or PCl5. So how to solve this type of problem? So at first, we also apply here our hybridization rule. So we just draw here in case SOF4. So when we get, so sulfur SOF4, when we also follow the rules, hybridization rule. So here the valence shell of sulfur, electron 6 electron present. So 6 plus here oxygen is diatomic, so we cannot count here. And here F is electronegative, so he has 4 F present. So 6 plus 4 by 2, here the value is 10 by 2 is equal to 5. And in case XCOF4, this one is our SR number. We also discussed previous our how to calculate SR number on this video. So please follow the rules. And here in case XCOF4, here xenon is present on this neon group. So the valence shell of xenon is 8 electron present. So 8 plus oxygen cannot count. F count is a 4. So 8 plus 4, 12 by 2, here 6 is present. 6 SR number. And in that case, third case, SOCl4, sulfur is present on that oxygen group. So 6 plus 4 by 2, 10 by 2 is equal to 5, SOCl4. And in case PA5, this one present on nitrogen group. So valence electron is 5 plus 5 by 2 divide by 2. So 10 by 2 is equal to 5. Now we also discuss the hybridization. What is the hybridization? So now we can calculate the hybridization. So in case SOF4, here total 4 is participant on covalent bond, participating bonding. So here 4 bond pair and 1 lone pair. We can easily see that SOF4. And but in that case XCOF4, here the value is 6. So here 4 and 5, 5 bond pair is present and 1 lone pair. And in that case, third case, here SOCl4, here presents 4 and 1 oxygen 5. So total 5 bond pair and 1 lone pair. And in that case PF5, here 5 bond pair. So now one missing is done here, one missing here. On that case SOCl4, here total 4 Cl and 1 oxygen take participate in covalent bonding. So here total presents 5 bond pair. But in that case square pyramidal molecular shape, we know that our octahedral case when presents 5 bond pair and 1 lone pair, in that case we also discuss our rules. The square pyramidal shape is and our lone pair is present on that way, and this our down bond and this one is our lone pair. So this one is our octahedral case and square pyramidal case. Square pyramidal case. So here in that case four bond pair, one lone pair, this option is cut. In case SOCN4, this option is cut. In case PF5, this option is cut. So answer is five bond pair, one lone pair according to our rules. So in case octahedral case, this one is our answer. So XC wave 4 is our answer. So the next problem is the hybridization in SF6 molecule sp3d2, sp2d3 and sp4 and sp3sp. How to calculate this type of problem? So in case SF6, we know here in case SF6 here sulfur is present on the oxygen group. So the valence electron of sulfur is 6 and total 6 fluorine atom present. So 6 plus 6 is equal to 2. Total when we calculate here 6 SR number. So how to calculate SR number? We also discussed previous 6 SR number. So here 6 SR number. So here 6 fluorine atom take participate in bonding. So in case SF6, when we get hybridization, so sp3, sp3 means 314, and d, 1 d is when add, then this one 1, 5. So when 1 excess d add, this one is our 1 d, the hybridization is 1. So total sp3d2 is our hybridization. We also say that. So the answer is sp2d3, this one is cut, sp4d4, this one is cut, sp3sp, this one is cut, sp3d2 is our answer. Now we discuss one of the important problem is here. The geometry around the central atom ClF4 plus is square planar, square pyramidal, octahedral, or trigonal bipyramidal. So at first we also draw the structure ClF4 plus. So here Cl presents in on that group oxygen. So no, sorry, fluorine. So here valence shell of electron of chlorine is 7 plus 4, but here 4F present. So here plus 4, but here 1 plus charge is present. So minus 1. So divide 2. So here total value is 10 by 2. So here 5 is our 5 SR number is present. Now we also discuss 5 SR number means here 4 A present. So 4 bond pair and 1 lone pair. So total hybridization of the structure is sp3 3 and 4 or sp3d. So this one is our square planar, not, because in case is planar, square planar, this one sp2, square pyramidal, this one is not, square pyramidal is sp3, octahedral, this one is not, but in case trigonal bipyramidal, this one is our correct answer. So the structure is present because in case trigonal bipyramidal, if you draw the shape of the structure, 4F atom present on that way and lone pair is present here. So this one is our trigonal bipyramidal. So we can find the answer to solve. So here the by using here the formula of SR number calculation, the formula is the valence shell of metal, valence shell electron of metal, valence shell electron of metal plus if the anion at which number of anion, so the number of anion, anionic charge, then charge, so divide 2. So we can get, we also discuss our formula in this discussion, so we can find the answer. One of the important problem is here, the structure is XC wave 5, ion is octahedral, distorted octahedral, pentagonal pyramidal, pentagonal bipyramidal. So try to explain this answer. So HCO A5-. So in case xenon is present on the group of neon, so valence electron is 8. Oxygen is diatomic, so we cannot count. Here F is present anionic, so 5 and 1 minus charge is present. So total 14/2. If you cut this, we get 7 SR number. And if you want to find the hybridization of 7, so sp3 means 4 and d3. So this one is represent 7 SR number. So we know that in case octahedral, this one belongs to sp3 d2, so the option is cut. And in case distorted, and in case pentagonal bipyramidal, in case when you follow pentagonal bipyramid, this one is sp3 d2, and in case pentagonal pyramidal, then if you get distorted octahedral case, here also contain sp3 d2, and pentagonal pyramidal case is not here accepted. But we also here find the number of bond pair and number of lone pair. So in that structure, here total 516 bond pair is present and 1 lone pair is present in case 7, because here 5 fluorine and 1 oxygen take participate in bond pair and 1 lone pair is present. So then we complete the 7 value, 6 plus 1, 7 value. So in that case, we know that distorted octahedral case here contained 6 bond pair and 1 lone pair. So we can easily say that distorted octahedron is the answer. But pentagonal pyramidal, if we cut, then distorted octahedral case is our answer. This one is sp3 d3 arrangement. So now we discuss our next problem, the structure which have square planar structure, BF4- FeCl4- SF4 yeah XCF4. So now we can calculate the, in case SF4, here sulfur is present on the group of oxygen, so SF4, here the valence shell of electron of sulfur is 6 plus 4/2. Total 10/2 is 5. So here presence total 4 bond pair, 1 lone pair. But in that case XCF4, here XCF4, here xenon is present on the group of neon. So now here total 8 of the valence electron of xenon plus 4 is our F, so divide 2. So total 12/2 is equal to 6. So in case 6 here, but here total 4 F fluorine atom take participate in bonding. So here 4 bond pair and 2 lone pair. Now this SR number is fulfilled. So we know that in that case 4 bond pair and 1 lone pair case. So here in case this one is our hybridization, when you show, so sp3 d2, so this one is our octahedral structure, but square planar octahedral according to rule 4 bond pair 2 lone pair, this one is our square planar. And what is the shape? So shape is when you can draw the lone pair, 2 lone pair is present on that manner, and this bond is up, and this one is our square planar structure. So the question is the structure which have square planar structure. So we get our answer XCF4. SF4, in that case 4 bond pair and 1 lone pair is present. So what is the structure of 4 bond pair and 1 lone pair? This one is our distorted tetrahedral. distorted tetrahedral. So the structure is our distorted tetrahedral is lone pair is present here, and this bond is down, this bond is our up, and this one two group is linear. This one is our distorted tetrahedral group SP, sorry SF4. So SF4 case the hybridization is SP3D, because here four bond is take participate in bonding. So 314 and one lone pair extra 415, total 5 SR number required fulfill. So the correct answer is XCF4, and in case FUCL4 it one not possible, and in case BF4 this one is not possible because boron is present here 3, and in case F atom 4, so 3 4 plus 3 7 and 1 8 divide 2. So this one structure is not fulfilled, this one is not fulfilled. So correct answer is XCF4. So friends, now we also complete our total discussion. We also find the every type, all types of structure by using these rules and this shortcut formula. So if any question, please contact me and mail me and comment. And if you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.